So YouTube, I'm back. If you're wondering what this disassembled nonsense is on my Nissan, I rarely show this car because I really have to work on it. It's the EGR valve. Why am I fucking with the EGR valve and what is all this? Well, this little motor spins down on here and the only thing I can figure is that, or excuse me, this little magnet, and that goes inside this motor that is the EGR valve. Ooh, that gets warm. As it spins, it also pushes down, opening the valve. So I've been having this issue where when my car idles, it just wants to die. I guess the EGR opens at idle on these, I don't really know. Normally I delete EGRs because they don't really do much other than cause problems on all my old junk. So anyway, I just stalled it, but you'll see why. You see how hard that was to start? Okay, so the EGR is closed now. But when this spins out like this, it can, that's open. And that my car is idling like shit anyway, and I don't know why. But that on top of it is definitely part of the issue. I don't want to run this too long because I don't want to get the engine too hot, but I'm trying to chase some vacuum leaks and other shit on here. But that is not going back in there. This will go back on here with the screws in it, and the computer will think it's telling the EGR to open, but it's not. So that's one problem solved. But this car has been so fucked with, it's just hard to tell what's wrong. But that's definitely part of it. Oh, there's also a carrier bearing in there. It sits on top. I guess that'd be a carrier bearing something. It sits up on top of the magnet. Which way's up? Like that. So that when it spins and, basically when it's screwing down in there, it's pressing the valve open. When it screws back, when it twists back up, it's closing the valve. So, motor spins, valve opens, car runs like a lawnmower. I don't know what all is wrong with this thing, but these earlier 1.8s had a bunch of shit that the later ones didn't. The 2000, I think, and 2 or 3, I know definitely 3, but maybe 2, but definitely 3 did not have an EGR. They only had one or two O2 sensors down here, not 4. None of the O2 sensors are throwing codes, by the way. The EVAP solenoid, which is also unhooked, because there's a vacuum leak somewhere that when that opened, it was killing my car, so, you know, it's just venting to the atmosphere as nature intended. You're welcome, Greta. Also, the vacuum line for my fuel pressure regulator was rotted out. I replaced it a while back. This vacuum line going down to that canister, which eventually goes to the MAP sensor, manifold absolute pressure, which I don't think the later ones have, or if they do, it's built onto the manifold somewhere. That line was rotted. That line was rotted. I'm chasing other vacuum leaks. I'm not going to run the car a lot right now. I don't want to be down there burning my hands because it's all down around this EGR shit. There's a bunch of vacuum down in there, and it's just... You think a carburetor runs bad on vacuum leaks? Try a damn computerized engine. Anyway, yeah, I'm just out here with what little vacuum hose I got and cheap Harbor Freight toolkit that I keep in the car so I don't have to carry all my tools with me. And, yeah, I didn't do that. It was like that when I got the self-tappers holding the radiator in. But it came with a new radiator, so I can overlook the self-tappers. And yeah, the clutch master's new. I had to have that done. New clutch, flywheel, masters, or slave, excuse me. Master, it's all new. But yeah. Needs a little work, but runs good. It just, when it idles, it's like a damn lawnmower. Shit pisses me off. So, yeah, I'm going to keep digging in, see what I can find, but I'm going to take it down the road here in a little bit and see if that helps. Run it for a bit, stop, idle, run it for a bit, stop, idle. Fun times. So yeah, that's not a vacuum leak. That's just going back to the evap canister in the back, which causes my car to die when it opens this solenoid, which was coincidentally cracked and leaking air itself. But when I hooked it up directly, it's too much air for the engine. It's supposed to be in that port there. But, it's just a mess. Anyway, I'll update as I go. Sorry I haven't been videos on. By the way, there's a teaser. The Chevy's gone, and yeah. Don't question me. So let's read the codes here, shall we? Come on. Car is on, by the way. It's not running, but it's on. MIL status, it's a check engine light. It is on. Three codes. Damn it, I was reading that. Never press the inner button on that screen to get past it if you have one of these Foxwell readers. Otherwise, you'll end up making it think your car's a Buick. And it's not. Unless it is, but mine is not. Ignition signal, primary. Okay, that was there before. I forgot to mention, but I put four junkyard coils on this thing that looked new. Okay. That's new. I don't like those. So let's back. Erase codes. Okay. Where's the any key? I don't see an any key. Let's run down to Walmart and see if those change. And by let's, I mean me and you will just have to wait a few seconds. Hello? Okay. Doesn't normally do that. It's new. I guess we'll see. So far we seem to be idling better. It's not perfect. It's still got a miss, but I wouldn't be surprised that's the case with this old car. Just plug that in. Someone's gonna be screaming, "Oh, plug in the OBD2 reader when the car is running. The port's always got power, dum-dum." Never had it have a problem. To see if it starts on that weird idle shit. I know a lot of it was a damn EGR valve. Whip. Damn it, I can't get the focus this time around. How about... That's gonna be awkward as shit to do, but... Whoops. Okay. There we go. No codes yet. Admittedly, I've only put about 20 miles on the car, but still got a funky idle, but it's not like it was. You heard it when that EGR opened. It was just ready to fall over and go and die. Okay, it's running in closed loop. I don't know if it's supposed to be open loop right now. Coolant temperature is only 177. That's nice to know, because that don't work. But I know it don't run hot. I don't know what those are. There's what I'm looking for. That's idling way low. But the throttle response is good. It's advancing spark like it should. Engine air temperature is 107 degrees. I don't feel like that out here. It's humid as hell. Them frogs are making a racket. Wait, what's going on with my throttle position sensor? Hang on. I'm gonna cut the engine off, leave the computer on, so I can do this. Oh! I don't know if that's right, but I got it flat to the floor and it's only reading 92.2%. The fuck? Oh, I turned it too far off. Whoops! God, those frogs sound like goddamn Jurassic Park out there. What is even happening? Oh, there we go. Reconnected. Okay, yeah, 91.8 flat to the floor. I might want to replace the throttle position sensor. Anyway. I don't know what any of this means, really. All I was looking for was the throttle position and the, that's good. By the way, when I got this car and first read the engine codes, the mill distance, that's a check engine light distance. That's one thing you want to check and see if your tool can scan. Because if you go to look at a car and they're telling you, yeah, the check engine light came on, it doesn't seem like anything serious, and you look at it, it's been like 47,000 miles of a check engine light, you know they're full of shit. And they're probably lying about other things, too. I got this car from an auction lot. No dealer wanted it because it's ugly as sin, but she's a good little car. She just had a rough life. So I guess that's it. I don't think there's anything else I can check. Yep, I guess I'll just have to wait and see if those catalyst ones come back. That's where the OBD2 port is in these cars. Right up there above where your clutch pedal would be if you had a clutch. If not, it'll be just left your brake pedal, which is here. And yep, sandals and driving a stick. That's me. And don't ask about all this, because this is your, like, that's this knob, the blur position. And your heater control is way back up in there. That one. Right now it's on full cold, because the AC does work. Have to take my word for it because you can't feel it, but why did you just beep? I think that means check engine light. What does that mean? What do you mean? My check engine light just, I don't know if it's supposed to be over there or over there, but it don't work. And by the way, that brake light's just my parking brake. Because it's a stick, and I don't want to go rolling backwards. Hello? Anyone home? Beep, beep, beep. I don't know what that light's about, but I don't have any check engine codes, and it seems to be running okay. And yeah, it does idle better with the AC on, but it also runs better with the engine under load, like, you know, so. But it's almost idling now, so. Good enough. Shut up. What do you want? I haven't a soul to give you. Oh yeah, and I put this Pioneer digital media receiver in here. This was all covered, but I was having a bad day and I was trying to set this to heat one night and my hand got stuck in there. And when I yanked my hand back, the whole dash cover came off. And I haven't replaced this because these are like 150 plus the last time I looked. And every single one I've pulled in the junkyard is broken in the same way where these cables clip in. Every one. I'm not even joking. I pulled apart at least 8 dashboards looking for this part in the junkyard. And it's only in the 2000 models, the 2000, or 2000, 2001. 2002 and 3 and 4 have these different buttons and shit. And it looks the same, it will bolt in, but if you plug it in, your AC won't work. Don't know why. Because I got one, or had one, in the back there. And it wasn't broke, but my AC didn't work. And then it broke. So I took it out and threw it in the back seat, and I think I threw it in the trash. Oh yeah, and this just now kind of chills. That's about as bad as it's gonna get, which is fine. That's gonna be like idling in a drive-thru. I don't know. It's a ratty old car with a lot of miles. Let's see, how many did it have? There you go. 253,627. And because of those miles and a hard life, the shifter is perpetually a bit flaccid. Still has some spring to the right, but all the gears are still there and good, though. It grinds sometimes when you go into fifth without, if you go like banging it out of third into fifth, it'll grind a little, so you gotta either double clutch it or just wait. Because the synchros aren't the best, and reverse is kind of screwy on these cars, but it even says in the manual, you gotta kind of go into first, then reverse. And it does have your usual front-wheel drive lockout that when you go into fifth, or most modern cars have this really, when you go into fifth, you can't go into reverse. There's a little gate there that comes out, but you can accidentally go into reverse if you start to go into fourth and over, so. Eh. And by the way, that is my shift knob for my Hyundai, because that's a thing. Anyway, I got ice cream melting over here, so I'm going to go in the house where it's not humidity of Florida land. But first, I like for the car to rest on the transmission, not the brake, because I don't entirely trust the brakes of this car. Yeah. Oh, that's another thing on the list. Oh, and the Pioneer radio has some hands-free calling, so I jabbed a hole in that and ran it through there. That hole I did not do. That was already there, but I used it for the camera. Not that I really care about this interior too much. It's not in the worst shape. I've seen cars with a lot less miles in a lot worse shape. Anyway, 10 minutes into the video, rambling. Thanks for watching, as usual. Have a good one.